because they now know everything there is to know about Scripture. So if you have a question, look at them and ask them just to see what they do. It'll be a lot of fun. This will be a wonderful time together, a wonderful time to simply celebrate the joy of God in our lives, but also this wonderful moment from them. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks once again because you've gathered us together, your children, to see how we may be able to set deeper roots in you, and that perhaps we can find joy, we can find hope, we can find strength in tough times, but ultimately, Lord, we can find you. May the blessing of this time truly touch our hearts, and may this wonderful day be a stepping stone for these wonderful youth. We pray this in your holy name. Amen.
The Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." They answered him, "We're descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean, saying you will be made free?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The son has a place there forever. So if the son makes you free, you will be free indeed." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Christ. You may be seated. God's grace and peace and love are yours in Jesus the Christ. Again, to echo Pastor Mark, thank you for being here to honor our confirmation class this year. It's a little different with everything this year. So we are split into 10:30 and noon services to honor this wonderful class of scholars in the Bible now. If you were listening as I just read that gospel, Jesus has a promise for us all in there. If the Son makes you free, you will be free. As you remember in our studies, right, confirmation students, we talked about Luther and how he found the good news of this freedom in the scriptures himself. After being tormented by not being able to make himself right with God, he found the good news in Romans 3:28 that we're justified by grace through faith. And that good news carried him and his movement into the world in a brand new way to celebrate God's gifts to all of us. Well, we're all in for a treat now as we hear from the confirmation students themselves what the good news is that they have to cling on to at this important milestone in their faith journey. So as I said, there's half of them here, but your booklet has all of the confirmation's faith statements in it. So we're going to go through here alphabetically with those who are here at this service. So that's Alex to start us out. Molly will read after that, and then just come up in turn.
Hello, my name is Alex Anschutz. My very first memory of Norway Lutheran Church is attending Mustard Seed Preschool. Then when I was old enough, I started attending Sunday school, and I eventually started attending confirmation classes at youth group. Through all of this, I memorized the Ten Commandments and pretended to know the Apostles' Creed. But please don't tell Pastor Christie. With all of these experiences, one thing that really stuck with me is to be kind to others, even if they are different from me. Through Mustard Seed Preschool and Sunday school, the action of being kind was reinforced and has led to unlikely friendships. Like my 85-year-old neighbor, Mr. P, who always says rain is better than snow because you don't have to shovel it, and Mr. P, my other neighbor, who has told me for the last couple of years that he's 95. He says the key to living a long life is not drinking or smoking, and he quit smoking when he was 13 because that was when they started putting filters on cigarettes. I started getting to know them very well when I started mowing their lawns and snow blowing the driveways. If I could take anything away from confirmation, it is that being kind and helping others is very important, and you can make some very good friends along the way. When I'm helping others, I'm reminded that the Lord is with me all the time, and I never need to be afraid.
has grown so much over the last 2 years. I have grown so much closer to the Lord, and I couldn't be happier. Confirmation taught me so much about God and Jesus, which helped me to relate to Him in some ways. In elementary school, when I was going to Sunday school, I never imagined that I would get this close to the Lord and have so much fun being a part of this church. I thought I was just going to class and learning about God. But once I got to confirmation classes, I really started to understand the Bible and connect with God and to Jesus' stories. While I was getting closer to the Lord through these last 2 years, I was not doing it alone. I have gotten so much help, whether it was from confirmation and youth group itself, Pastor Christy, my parents, my friends, and all the people that helped me with class, or Jimmy. Jimmy was one of the people who helped me the most. He is so connected with God, and he helped me too. Faith is one of the most important things in my life. It has helped me with every struggle that I've had. One of the promises we made to become confirmed is to stay a part of God's church. This may be hard, but I think it is going to be one of the biggest promises I am going to keep throughout the rest of high school and more. Church has always been a great experience, especially when I attend other events such as Vacation Bible School, Luther Daily Retreats, mission trips, youth group, confirmation, etc. Confirmation classes really made me think of what my faith really means to me. I noticed throughout my 7th and 8th grade career, I ended up letting go and letting my faith guide me to where I needed to go. During this time, I was a little skeptical of my faith. These last 2 years, I have been through so much. My aunt passing away of cancer, my great-grandma passing away, switching schools, my sister going off to college, my grandpa dealing with the daily struggle of Alzheimer's, and not to mention finishing my 8th grade year over a screen. One night, as I was just finishing up online schools, something told me to go visit grandpa. During this time, I had been super stressed out dealing with school, signing up for high school, and taking care of my showcase. I hopped on the four-wheeler to go visit my grandparents. As I walked in, the biggest smiles appeared on both of their faces, and it immediately made my day so much better. As we talk and talk, my grandpa looks up at me randomly and says something I'll truly never forget. He says, "Good job. Keep doing what you're doing. I am so proud of you." For those of you who don't know my grandpa, Alzheimer's has taken over him, and it is very hard for him to remember people, do simple tasks, and even put words together. Therefore, him saying these words made me so beyond happy. I knew at that exact moment those words didn't just come from my grandpa, but from God also. God saw me struggling, and he knew exactly how he could get a message through to me. Over the next several months, I paid more attention to the little things. I didn't let my brain get wrapped up and stressed about every little thing. And most importantly, I paid more attention to my grandpa. I paid attention to how happy he was over the little things. I listened to him talk about the farm, which he was so passionate about. I listened to the little random things he would say, and I knew exactly where they were coming from. I truly believe he is God's messenger. Even though it is so very hard watching Alzheimer's take over him, I wouldn't want him any other way. My grandpa is the most happy, inspirational, and silly person I know. I wouldn't change that for the world. What I'm trying to say is pay attention to the others around you, be grateful for the little things, and live every day with you.
From that first day, I knew Christ was by my side. It was extremely difficult to be a new student in a school that was so small. My family moved, and our old church was too far from us now, so we started going less. I just to go closer with God during the times I was not able to go to church. Middle school was hard for everyone, but having Christ by my side made it so much better to wake up and do anything throughout the day. I felt as if I was more alive when I prayed, and I got along with him better. Some days I would be super happy, and I knew that was because of him. Other days I would be sad, and I would blame it on him. But you cannot blame anyone for your bad days. Knowing that, I could always go back on my phone or look in my Bible, which is bright and on my day. Christ will always be bright in my pocket if I need him. Now that I'm at Norway, I feel closer to my church family and the surrounding community. There are enough people in my little church community now to remember and keep in my heart for helping me through this two-year journey. Even though I have only been at Norway for a little while and a member for 1 year, it feels like I just belong here. I would just like to take the time to thank all the people in my life for bringing me through this church experience and being there for me all the time. Pastor Christy, Jimmy, and Pastor Mark, thank you for all the funny jokes and the time well spent learning about Christ. This is one more step of my faith growth that is now completed. I could not have done it without you. Thank you. rocky bunny right above where she had planted the cross. Ever since then, she viewed bunnies as a sign from God, and she has passed this belief onto my sister and me. In our family, bunnies are a God sign. Whenever we see a bunny, we know it's God's way of giving us a sign that he and our loved ones who have passed away are with us. Bunnies have not been the only way I've seen God at work in my life. Some big ways I've seen him is whenever I've helped with JAM and Vacation Bible School here at church. By helping kids grow their faith and learn about God with them, I feel that I am creating a stronger connection with God and helping the kids create their own connections too. Going through confirmation classes, I have been able to realize what it truly means to have a strong faith. By learning about different Bible stories, I have the ability to interpret the meaning of God's endless love for us. In the end, God has found many ways to come back to me whenever I lose sight of him. He reminds me who I am, who is truly there for me, and what makes me the person I am today. I appreciate all that I have learned on my faith journey from Pastor Mark, Pastor Christy, and Jenny, and throughout Sunday school, confirmation, and youth group. I cannot wait to continue to grow my faith as a member of Northern Lutheran Church.
Pretty amazing group of young people, right?
Yeah.
We're very proud of all of them. And the growth that I've seen in the last couple of years, the growth Jimmy's seen as you mature in your faith and your walk in life, and our sincere hope and prayer for each and every one of you is that you know that you are indeed a loved child of God. You're a loved member of this family of faith here at Norway Lutheran Church. And you will always have a place here. You will always have friends and family here to support you through whatever life may bring. And you will always have the good news that the Son has made you free. And you are free indeed. Amen?
Amen.
grace and mercy that is praying for the church, the world, and all those in need. Renew and inspire the church in the freedom of the gospel of God. Where the church is in error, reform it. Where the church speaks your truth, strengthen it. Where the church is divided, unify it. Ignite in us the working of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Release those living in bondage to death, chronic pain, or addiction. Grant healing touches to those who are ill, especially Jack and Kathleen, Jan and Herb, Katie and Beth, Hayden and Maggie, Wally and Johanna, Patty and Donna, Lee and Christine, Nancy and Norma, Joanna and Mark, Steve, Diana, Stephen and Karen, Audrey, Janet, Robert and Ron, Mark, Aaron, Gary and Mike, Erica, Pam, Jerry and Brendan, and all who are suffering from COVID-19, and anyone else we lift up aloud or we hold in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bring comfort to all who are far away from home, especially those serving in our military, whether in training or in combat, or just stationed far away. We ask you, Lord, to be with Joe, to be with Peter, Josh and Brett and Caroline, be with Jake and Bryce, Richard, Andrew, and Lucas, and all who serve our country, that we love, and we pray that you watch out for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In this family of faith, we give thanks for the 14th Confirmand, affirming their faith this weekend. Bless them, Lord. Keep them to your word. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Listen as we call on you, O God, and fold in your loving arms all for whom we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You may be seated from the affirmation of baptism.
Dear friends, we give thanks for the gift of baptism and for these people, one with us in the body of Christ, who are making public affirmation of their baptism today. Will the confirmands please stand as their names are read?
Alex Anschutz, Molly Brever, Ashley Gunderson, Brianna Crow, Daniel McFarland, Julia Runty, and Audrey Schoenfeld.
Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for these sisters and brothers whom you have made your own by water and the word of baptism. You have called them to yourself, enlightened them with the gifts of your Spirit, and nourished them in this community of faith. Uphold your servants in the gifts and promises of baptism, and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ.
Amen.
I now ask you, confirmants, to profess your faith in Jesus Christ, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? Do you believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. Come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You have made public profession of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people, following the example of Jesus, and and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth. And people of God, do you promise to support these sisters and brothers and pray for them in their life in Christ?
We do. We ask God to help and guide us.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin, and raise us to eternal life. You may be seated. We'll call each confirmand and their families forward at this time. I call Alex. Now I'm going to ask the class to rise one more time. Face your family and friends that you came with here today. Let us rejoice with these sisters and brothers in Christ. We rejoice with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all the world. This is our confirmation class, at least half of it, for 2020. Applause is appropriate.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks, and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the covenant of my blood, and shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. When you gather as my family, do this to the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thy kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My beautiful family, God's feast has been prepared, and everyone is welcome. Pastor Christy and I will go and prepare ourselves, and as we come back, we invite you to simply come forward, and we will give you communion at the rail. You may be seated. We give you thanks, gracious God, that you have once again fed us with food beyond compare, the body and blood of Christ. Lead us from this place, nourished and forgiven, into your beloved vineyard to wipe away the tears of all who hunger and thirst, guided by the example of the same Jesus Christ and led by the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Father in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you and lead you into the way of truth and life. Amen. Our closing song is Burning in My Soul.
Let's go.